Hello learners, my name is Dr. Priya Mahajan and I am from Department of Commerce. Our today's session is on debt market in India. In our previous session of financial market, we have discussed that financial market has two segments, capital market and money market. Money market has further two segments, unorganized market and organized market. This section we have already done in my previous sessions on financial market and money market instrument. Now on the other hand, there is a capital market. Capital market has two segments, equity market and debt market. Equity market is a market where shares are issued and traded in a stock exchange, and this is the riskiest market. On the other hand, there is a debt market. Our today's session is completely devoted on the debt market. And learners, debt market is comparatively less riskier than the equity market. Now, what is debt market? Debt market refers to the financial market where fixed income securities of various types and features are issued and traded. Learners, fixed income securities are those securities where the investors, they get fixed income in the form of interest annually and semi-annually. This market is an important source of funds, especially in a developing economy like India's. And also, learners, debt market is one of the largest markets in Asia. The total size of the Indian debt market is currently estimated to be in the range of $115 billion to $200 billion. India's debt market accounts for approximately 30% of its GDP. The Indian debt market in terms of various volume is larger than the equity market. The most important feature of the debt market instrument of Indian debt market is that the return is fixed. These returns are almost risk-free. This fixed return on the bond is often termed as the coupon rate or the interest rate. Therefore, the buyers of the bonds is giving the seller a loan at a fixed interest rate, which equals to the coupon rate. Next is the classification of Indian debt market. Indian debt market is broadly classified into government securities market and corporate bond market. Corporate bond market include both public and private companies. So first one is government securities market. It consists of central and state government securities. It means that loans are being taken by the central and state governments. The government securities market accounts for more than 90% of the turnover in the debt market. It covers the principal segment or the major segment of the debt market. Government security is a claim on the government. It is an absolutely secured financial instrument which guarantees the certainty of both income and capital. It is therefore also called a gilt-edged, which means of the best quality security or stock. Next is the bond market. It consists of financial institutions bond, corporate bonds and debentures, public sector unit bonds. These bonds are issued to meet financial requirements at a fixed cost and hence remove uncertainty in financial cost. Learner, the Indian bond market measured by the estimated value of the bond outstanding is next only to the Japanese and Korean bond market in Asia. So Indian bond market stands at number 3 in the Asia in terms of bond market. Next are the major players in debt market who issue debt securities. So first one is this state government and central government. The largest segment of the Indian debt market covered by government securities, where the daily trading volume is in excess of ₹2,000 crore, with instruments tenure ranging from the short dated treasury bill to long dated securities extending up to 30 years. Another is government, non-government entities, and this includes banks, financial institutions, insurance companies, mutual funds, primary dealers, and corporate entities. So these are the major players in debt market who issue debt securities and raise loan or funds from the market. Next, we will discuss about the debt instruments. So these are the various kinds of debt instruments which are available in the Indian debt market. These are the certificate of deposits, commercial papers, treasury bills, corporate bond, national savings schemes, and fixed deposits. So we'll discuss each of these instruments one by one. So first one is the certificate of deposits. Certificate of deposit is a negotiable instrument issued by banks and issued to depositors. Depositors include individuals, companies, trusts, funds, associations, etc. for a specified period ranging less than 1 year. So basically they are money market instruments whose maturity period is less than 1 year. But in 1993, the RBI allowed the financial institutions like IFCI, IDBI, IRBI and Exim Bank to operate in it. And these institutes, they issue CDs or certificate of deposit for the maturity period above 1 year and up to 3 years. So anyone who want to invest in this certificate of deposit, they have to do minimum investment of rupees 1 lakh. Next is the commercial paper. So commercial papers were introduced in January 1990. These are short-term unsecured promissory notes generally issued by corporate entities. These are issued with the maturity of 7 to 365 days. So they are also money market instruments. They are issued by the corporate houses, and only those corporate houses which are listed on the stock exchange and whose working capital is not less than 5 crore, only such corporate houses can issue the commercial paper. Companies issue commercial papers need to obtain a specified credit rating from the various agencies like CRISIL, ICRA, CARE, etc., which are approved by the RBI. Next is the treasury bills. Treasury bills are used by central government to fulfill its short-term liquidity requirement up to the period of 364 days. They are issued by RBI on behalf of central government. The variants of treasury bills are 91-day treasury bill, 182-day treasury bills, 364-day treasury bills. So these are the different types of treasury bills which are available. And these treasury bills are the short-term investment avenue for the banks and financial institutions. Treasury bill fulfill the statutory liquidity ratio requirement of these financial institutions also. Next are the corporate bonds. Bonds are an important source of funds to the corporate sector. These bonds come from public sector undertakings and private corporations and are offered for an extensive range of tenure up to 15 years. They represent a promise by a company to the bondholder to pay specified rate of interest during a stated time period maturity and return of the principal sum on the date of maturity. The date of maturity is also called the date of retirement of a bond. Bonds are of many kinds. The difference in bonds is due to the terms and conditions and features of each bond's bearer. Compared to government securities, corporate bonds carry higher risk, which depend upon the corporation, the industry where the corporation is currently operating, the current market conditions, and the rating of the corporation. However, these bonds are also give the higher return than the government securities, because these corporate bonds, they carry a higher risk than the government securities, so they also provide higher returns than the government securities. Here is the list of different types of bonds. These are convertible bonds, serial bonds, sinking fund bonds, mortgage or secured bonds, collateral trust bonds, income bonds, adjustment bonds, assumed bonds, joint bonds, redeemable and irredeemable bonds, participating bonds. So these are the different types of bonds which are issued by both public and private sector companies. Next comes the fixed deposits or FDs. Fixed deposits are one of the most popular mode of investment among the large section of investors in India as a safe investment option for a long period. A fixed deposit account allows to deposit the money for a set period of time, thereby earning a high rate of interest in return. Fixed deposit or FDs also give higher rate of interest than a saving bank account. Any investment portfolio should be right mix of safe, moderate, and risky investments. Mutual funds and equity shares. They are considered to be the risky investments, whereas these FDs, government bonds, government securities, etc., they are considered to be the safe investments. The banks give interest rate depending on this loan amount and the tenure of the deposits. So higher the loan amount or the tenure of the deposit, higher will be the rate of interest provided by a bank on these FDs. Next are the National Savings Schemes or NSS. National Savings Schemes have been started by Government of India mainly to finance the economy development plans through the mobilization of savings of smaller income groups. These schemes are operated mainly through the post offices. These are of tax-free nature schemes, so it attracts higher income group of people also. The rate of interest on these schemes are usually higher than the commercial banks. So these schemes include the National Savings Certificates, Indira Vikas Patra, Kisan Vikas Patra, Saving Deposit and Fixed Deposit with the post offices. So next come, so these are the different schemes of the different types of debt instruments which are available in the Indian market. Next is the regulation of debt market in India. So regulation of debt market in India means who regulate or who control the debt market in India. So these are the two agencies, this SEBI and RBI, who regulate the Indian debt market. The RBI regulate the government securities market and money market, while corporate debt market, both public and private, comes under the control of SEBI. In March 2000, government issued a notification and described the area of responsibility between the Reserve Bank of India and SEBI. The contract for sale and purchase of government securities, gold-related securities, money market instruments, repos contract in debt market, they shall be regulated by the RBI. Whereas such contract, if executed on the stock exchange, shall, however, be regulated by SEBI in a manner that is consistent with the guidelines issued by the RBI. So this is how debt market is regulated in the India. Next is the primary and secondary segment of the debt market. Like equity market, debt market also has the primary and secondary segment. In primary segment, new debt securities are floated or issued either through the public prospectus, right issues or private placements. So these are the different modes through which these debt instruments, they are issued or floated in the market. In the secondary market, debt instruments are trading on the over-the-counter exchange of India, that is OTCEI, the BSE and the wholesale debt market segment of the NSE. Learners, the BSE is the first exchange in the country to provide an electronic trading platform for corporate and other non-government debt instruments through the order matching system. The clearing and settlement of trades is undertaken through the clearing house of the exchange. The NSE, that is National Stock Exchange of India Limited, set up a separate segment for the trading in debt securities known as the wholesale debt market segment of the exchange in June 1994. Prior to these separate segment of NSE, the only trading mechanism available in the debt market was the telephone. So trading in the debt market was done before these BSE and NSE electronic platform was done through the telephone only. The NSE provided for the first time in the country an online autonomous screen-based system known as NEET, that is National Exchange for Automated Trading, across a wide range of debt instruments. NEET supports an anonymous order-driven market and also provides online market information system. So learner, this is all about the debt market and debt market securities and instruments available in India. I hope this session gave you some useful insights about the debt market. Thank you.